Well, over here in the UK, it is morning. And I thought I'd, hello Double Dad, I thought I'd take advantage of the, what was a nice sunny morning. It's now turned a bit overcast. So if this broadcast suddenly goes dead, you'll know why, because it's raining. But here we are in the garden. As you can see, I've got a music stand here holding the iPad. We will see how we get on. If you have any questions, I'll do my best to answer them. We will see. Anyway, finger knitting. That's going to be the subject of this particular broadcast. See what I have here? This is what we're familiar with, aren't we? The chain. We do it over our finger, put it across, do it over again, put it across. We've all done that when we were little. Made hairbands and rings and presents for, I don't know, all our school chums, etc. But what if you take that a stage further? Now, slight difference in size, but what have I done different? Basically nothing. Instead of using one finger, which you can see here at the beginning, we've used four. Same process, but it makes a much larger and much more pleasing effect. Now if you look at the difference here, why is it so different from here through to here? Well, that basically is the same thing that would happen if you were knitting with knitting needles. But in this case, it's your fingers that are the knitting needles. Look at the thickness of one finger here, the little finger, and the thickness of the larger fingers. That is why the stitches are different sizes, because of your portable knitting needles. So, how do we do this? How do we progress from that to that? Well, first of all, we need some yarn. So I'm going to start with some nice big bulky yarn. So the larger the yarn, the larger what you end up with. That's what I'm trying to say. If you use thin yarn like this one I have here, you will end up with a much thinner project. So let's start with this one here. Put this toe on the side. Excuse my feet in the broadcast. That's how I'm sitting. Alright, so we're going to make a loop first of all. The easiest way to make a loop is to grab hold of the ends, pinch there. You don't have to make a loop, this is what I do. Okay, twist it around, put your thumb through there and grab that top one. And then just, boom, nice and easy. I'll do it again. Grab that end, around there, twist, grab, pull. Nice and simple. That one's going to go in your thumb. You don't need to keep it all in your thumb all the time. It's just to anchor it for the first couple of rows. And then you can take it off and get it in the way otherwise. So, there we go. So here's a nice long length. We start off by going behind Double Diode. I think you have yarn with you. Why don't you get some yarn out and have a go too? It's right there in front of you on the table. So, behind the first finger, in front of the second. Behind, in front. Now we go back along the same route. So we're weaving in and out our portable knitting needles, your fingers. We're going to keep going until you've got two strands on each finger. There you go. Now what we end up with here is exactly the same thing we had when we're doing finger knitting, this kind, on one finger. Except for now we have it on all four. So starting at the little finger, we're going to start this end, bring the one that's nearest your hand up and over. Now you can bend your fingers to help with the process. So grab the bottom one, bend your finger and put it over the top. Alright, now go onto the second, and the third, and the fourth. So you've just done some knitting. There we go. Now with this nice long thread here, give your fingers a wiggle and gently pull on that. You're tightening the stitches, that's what you're doing there. There is your first stitch. And if you turn it over, I think it's not particularly great. But you haven't finished yet. You just keep going. Do exactly what you did before. Go around the back, cross the front, around the back, cross the front. Get two stitches on each finger. Now that basically is all you do. And you just keep going. And when you're happy with the length of knitting you have, then you can cast off. There we are. We've got again. Tightens it up. Behind, and you just keep on going. Now you'll find that you can just carry on doing this while you're talking, watching television. The youngsters When we were teaching the youngsters in the library the other day, I beg your pardon, this was back in February, we're going to be back in the library again soon. While I think of it, now that you've got the first few stitches on here, you can take off the thumb. It was just to anchor at the beginning. Let it drop. Won't do any harm back there. So, I was saying with the youngsters, when we were teaching the youngsters in the library, they were fascinated. And they went away with their piece of yarn, and they just carried on. And then they posted photographs on Facebook so we could see. You see our Facebook and Twitter down there. We're also on, what else are we on? Instagram and obviously here on Periscope too. So please follow us. We'd love to see you all there. And when you have done something, please post your photographs or even a little video. We'd love to see it all in action. Look, you see how it's growing, look. Oh yeah. Text is too small. What for here? Right, it was a bit hard for me to bend down, but I'll do my best. Just a second. Oh, yeah, without knocking everything. Mm. There we are. That's us, Cornish Crafty Girls. And here, as it says, you can find us on Facebook and Twitter and see videos and tutorials on our YouTube channel. Oh, I feel about YouTube. Oh, look at those hearts. Thank you, whoever you are. Just search for Cornish Crafty Girls, and there's the email if you want us as well. So on YouTube and Facebook, where else is it? Instagram, we are Cornish Crafter Girls. Now because Twitter and Periscope are linked together and they have a smaller amount of letters that we're allowed to use, we're actually on Twitter as Cornish Crafty G and Periscope Cornish Crafty G because there's not enough room to put our whole name in it. But there we go. So have a hunt, you'll find us, and YouTube as well, of course. We're trying to flesh out YouTube a little bit, but we'll see how we get on. Anyway, I'll put this on the floor. Ooh. There we go. I've got that straight. Excuse the feet. There we are. I'll do. Feet are more useful than we think. There we are. So, back to this. Seven people watching. Hello, seven people. How wonderful to have you. So, in case you just joined us, what we're doing is we're learning how to knit with four fingers rather than just the one. We've often done. I can put my piece of yarn on the floor. Excuse me again. Now then, there we go. So, this is one, for those that have just joined us, this is one finger knitting. This is four finger knitting. Now, it curls around naturally because the larger finger produces larger stitches, the smaller finger produces smaller stitches, just like ordinary knitting needles do. Now some have asked, what can we use it for? My goodness, how long is a piece of string? Or should I say, how long is a piece of yarn? You can use it for so many different things. What we've done before, is because you can straighten it. I won't do it on this one because it's a demonstration piece. But this is quite flexible, so you can stretch it out to make it a long. In fact, I've got a piece here. There we are. You can stretch it out, like here. And what I've done after that is I've actually arm knitted. Anyone seen arm knitting? Maybe that's another tutorial we ought to have a go at. One in seven people. Anyone seen arm knitting? Yes, no? No, yes? Let us know you're still there. You can arm knit with it, and of course that makes it even bulkier too. And with that you can then use it for scarves, you can use it for... There's one thing I have done recently, I've arm knitted it, was it fingered twice? No, I've arm knitted it, but very tightly. So, you know when you've got youngsters at home and the doors, you're always worried to get your fingers caught in the doors? Well, basically, it's really, really thick, much thicker than this, and it goes over the handles on each side of the door, and this bit here goes on the actual, you know, this part of the door, with the handles there and there. Stops the doors from actually slamming on little fingers, which is rather handy. Back to the finger knitting. Now, I'll keep on going with this. Ask any questions if you have any, and we'll see how we get on. So, behind the first finger, in front of the second. Keep going until we have two on each finger. Bend the little finger down to help with the process of knitting. And really that is all there is to it. And I shall keep on going here, just so that you can see how, shall I say, mind-numbingly easy this actually is. Because your flexible fingers are easier at helping your knitting along, it makes it so much easier to do because you can bend these knitting needles. Whereas a real knitting needle, she can't. Do you know, the wind has just picked up slightly out here, and there's a wonderful aroma of a lily wafting down. We've got a It's like a tiger lily, that sort of thing. Wafting down the garden. I wish she had smelloscope rather than just periscope. Because it is lovely. It's just enough wind to push it down this way. But not too much to push it out of the way. Lovely. And I wish Astrid was here, actually, because Astrid was following us while we were looking at the poppies and other plants in the garden. And I haven't seen her for a little while here on Periscope. And she wanted to see some of the other flowers. So Astrid, if you're watching, let us know you're there. Oh, hello, heart. Thank you, heart. There we go. So, behind the first, behind the second. And you're going to keep on going. Do you see how easy this is? It really is that easy. And I think it's much more pleasing to have... What have I done there? Hey, do you know what I've done there? What I've done there? I'm going to go backwards. I've actually forgotten to take off a couple. Because I'm looking down on top of my machine. It's easy to take off. Easy to put back on your finger again. What I've done, because I'm looking down and the light is actually shining on the iPad. I can't actually see what I'm doing. There we are, look. Just take it off. There we go. So, it is really that easy to put back on again. One, two. It's much, much easier than ordinary knitting. Because you know what it's like when you're doing ordinary knitting? It's the right pain when you drop a stitch. No, I actually can't. I'm going to towards me a second, because I can't actually see what I'm doing through the iPad's eyes. Give me a second. So, let's see what we've got. So we have... So what things do you think we could use finger knitting for? Anybody got any ideas? Have you ever done finger knitting yourself? Maybe there's some ideas that you have that you can let me know. And maybe we can incorporate it one day into a scope. There we are. That's back on my fingers again now. So let's see what we've got. There we are. So back to the beginning again. It's much easier to see it when you're see it without looking through the lens of a camera first. So basically, oh, there again, look, silly me. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Oh, can't see through the machine. There we go. Right, that's better. So basically we're going to keep on going like that until we've got a whole bunch of it. Now over here, in true Blue Peter fashion, is one I prepared earlier. So rather than carrying on this one here, let me show you what I have done. So down at the library this afternoon, or actually whatever day it is we decide to go down to it, they are doing, all the libraries here in Bridgewater, are actually running a summer reading challenge. I do it every year, and this year's theme is record breakers. And one thing they've asked us to do is to see how long, here we go, see? There we go, ta-da! See how long finger knitting that we can do. Well, so far, this is what we've got. Now this is my cardboard hand. So much easier, so that you can just take it off, pop it on your hand, and you haven't lost your spot. Although, like I showed you earlier, it is very easy to pick up your spot. So you see how long this is. Look, we're just in loads of different colours. This is a thin one, as you can see. It's still four fingers, but it's much thinner. You can use it with any yarn you want to. Doesn't matter what thickness it is. If you can spin it around your fingers, then you can finger knit with it. So here we are, look, we keep going. Da-da-da-da. Here we are, that's what we've done so far. And we're going to see how long we can get it over the summer holidays. And hopefully the youngsters will be joining in with us as well in the library. And then they can go home also, and they can bring some more yarn with them, all finger knitted up, to the library for the next time they come in, because they've got to read about six books, I think, over the summer holiday to qualify for their stickers and things. And while they're doing that, they can come and do some finger knitting and add to our mini local record. So it's not an official record breaker, but it's a Bridgewater breaker. How about that? Well, look, now you've got the idea of finger knitting. We shall put this video on YouTube as well, so you can go and refer to it if you want to see it again. But, like you said, oh, just throw it on the floor. That's good. Oh, my word. There we go. So, like you say, difference between the two. One finger knit, four-fingered finger knitting. Quite different. And the effect is quite nice actually. So I'll leave it at that. Any questions, come and ask us over on Facebook or Twitter or Instagram or YouTube or here on Periscope next time we're on. If you favourite our page here, channel, you'll get informed when we have another go at doing something, and we'll let you know how we're getting on with the finger knitting challenge too. Thank you for watching, appreciate your time, and I'm going to go now, and hopefully it's not going to rain because I don't want to get wet. Thank you, bye now.